Marion Doug, what is it about Project Turnabout that you would choose as a charity? What made you want to support us?
I'm originally from Grand Falls, and so back in the day when it was being built, my father was with Grand Falls Ready Mix, and as a young child, I just really remember going out to that site and saying, look at all those rocks up there, how is this building going to be built? And it's true, I mean, it's the bedstone of, you know, granite, and you had to, so I have that vivid memory of Project Turnabout being built in granite. And then through the years, of course, we know people that have received services from Project Turnabout, and it's just something that we feel is important to build people up, help them in low times. And if this is a service that can help people, that's something that we feel is a benefit to women, men, children, families. We're both retired school teachers, and we know that any kind of addiction, it affects family lives, and it just doesn't stop with that individual.
And part of being teachers is we know that the playing field isn't always the same. And both of our fathers were businessmen, and giving us the knowledge that you give back to your community and to the people that need help is kind of the way we were raised. The feeling that you get out of giving is indescribable when you can make somebody's life different. And like you said, with the addiction, some of those people don't choose to be that way. It just happens. And our hearts go out to that. And we have friends involved with Turnabout, and they guided us too and helped us make this decision, and we felt it was right.
Sherry was a dear friend of ours, and when we lost her, and knowing that she wanted to do good, and her husband for others, and thought that was just something very easy to hop onto. So, and it was tangible, and we could see it, and the house is beautiful, and you know, the original owners, and so we just wanted to make sure that that facility, that building, that home went to a good cause, and it's just an awesome experience for women. And I think women have a particular challenge because, you know, the heartstrings of possibly having children, and you're the matriarch of family sometimes. Like Doug said, it's not always your choice, and we don't know if we're out of the woods either, and if we might need some services down the road, or our children, or grandchildren, or relatives.
The night that we visited, just listening to how they were going to hold these patients accountable, and the life lessons that they were going to be learning that we took for granted, or we do take for granted, people know this stuff, and not everybody does. Living from paycheck to paycheck, skipping meals, feeling bad for your family because you're not providing what they need, and falling into this trap. And that's kind of, that night was really powerful for me.
The safety net of the different levels, and you know, we can fall down, but we know that you have a safety net for them, and build them back up, and they're not on the street. So I think the education part of women being able to help women or women, but make sure that, you know, with Ridgewater College right here, I mean, it's just such a no-brainer to be able to tap into the services that we have. We're a regional center, and it's important that we use all of our resources, and it's just a great natural fit.
I have found the people that have been involved that were patients want to get back. If they get control of their life to the point they want to be part of helping someone else. And that to me is extremely important, that these people come back, be counselors, work here, help people, guide them.
And you never know who you run into. I had one of my college friends whose mother was had trouble with gambling and had gone through our program, your program, Turnabout program, and you know, just seeing her come from about 200 miles away to come and visit her mother, and she'd stay with us, and just knowing the agony and the struggles of her seeing her mother in going through the steps or the program. And I think you just never know who this place is going to touch. And might not be today, but might be tomorrow.
I was contacted by a teacher friend of mine's daughter, who no longer is with us. And she shared with me the letter that I had written her to help her get through her addiction phase of alcohol, and told me how much it meant. And the daughter and myself had not been in contact for 25, 30 years. And all of a sudden, out of the clear blue sky, she saw my name and got a hold of me. And we have reestablished a relationship because I knew her mom and her dad very well. And it was neat what she said to me, how important it was and how I made her feel and how I opened up her life to helping her remember mom the way she was. And this teacher was a very wonderful person and didn't struggle until later, after, towards the end of her career is when she started struggling. And like I said, it just snuck up on her. Nobody would have known.
What do you hope for us at Turnabout for the future?
I think just for us, giving is, it's one way, you know, of giving back. It's a little bit of money. A little bit goes a long way. And I don't have the skills to help people in their struggle and their journey of recovery, but other people do, and that's why we have you. And I think that's what's important about for me for giving is being able to provide that the resources so that others can be lifted up, and because we all are productive, great people, and our society is better when we're working and towards a better end. So I think that's my reasons for giving.
Mine is every little bit counts. You know, somebody might be able to give huge amounts because they're able to do so, but even the littlest amount is better than nothing at all. And I think when we started giving, we had children and they weren't grown up. Now our children are gone and grown up. And it's different for us. We started out small and started moving up, and we will continue to do that. That's our hope and dreams. Mm-hmm.